Hello everyone, today in this video we will know about the amendments made in TCS, that is tax collected at source, in 2020, and along with this we will see that how you will be able to collect TCS from parties with these amendments in Marg software. So let's come and know about the amendments made in TCS. The government has added a new subsection 1H under section 206C in income tax, which means that if you are selling goods within India, then you need to collect TCS from your buyer. If the turnover of the seller is greater than rupees 10 crore from the previous financial year and sells goods exceeding rupees 50 lakhs, and along with it, if the buyer has provided their PAN card, then the seller will collect 0.075% TCS on the bill amount from the buyer. And if the buyer has not provided a PAN card, then the seller will collect 0.1% TCS from the buyer. And you will take care of one thing, that this amendment will be applicable from 1st October 2020. Now after that, let's come and see its process in the Marg software. For this, you will go to Masters, then to Marg Setups, and then go to Control Room. And here we will search TCS and click on Accept. Here you will get an option that if you want to apply TCS on bill amount along with all the taxes like GST, cess, etc., then you will select Y. If you want to apply TCS on amount plus GST, then you will select O. If you want to apply TCS on amount only, then you will select E. And if you don't want to apply TCS, then select No. So you will select the option as per your requirement. Then next is calculate only if customer sales cross 50 lakhs. It means that if the sale of the customer is above 50 lakhs, then TCS will get calculated on it. Next is calculate from date. As TCS is applicable from 1st October 2020, so by default that date will already been mentioned in it, that is 1st October 2020. After that, next is percentage on PAN customer. It means that if the customer provides their PAN card, then 0.075% TCS will get collected. And if the customer does not provide a PAN card, then 0.10% TCS will be charged. And now press Escape key and click on Yes to save the changes. After this, you will go to Masters, then to Ledger Master, then to Ledger, and then click on Modify Ledger. And now here you will press Enter key on the party and then go to Other Detail. Then you will see that TCS applicable option will be shown to you. And now suppose if you want to apply TCS on this party, then select Charge. Next is Ask Charge. Means if you want, when you do billing for this party, then the software must ask before charging TCS on the bill amount, then select Ask Charge. Next is Auto Check and Charge. It means if you want that if the total sales crosses 50 lakhs, then the software must first auto check that whether the TCS will be applicable or not, and then charge TCS on the bill. So you will select Auto Check and Charge. And once the software has auto checked and charged TCS on the bill amount, then from next time it will directly charge TCS on the bill amount for this party. Next is Auto Check and Ask. It means if you want that if the total sale crosses 50 lakhs, then the software must first auto check and then ask whether to charge TCS on bill or not for this particular party. So you will select Auto Check and Ask here. So you will select the option as per your requirement. And take care of this thing, that when you create a new financial year and the ledgers in which you have set charge, then auto check and charge will get set there automatically. And in the ledgers where you have set ask charge, then their auto check and ask option will get selected. Then press page down key and save the changes. After that, now we will generate the sale bill, select the ledger, then select the item, and then press tab key and save the bill. Then now you can see that an alert message of TCS has been displayed, where it is being shown that this particular party has a PAN number and 0.075% TCS is applicable on the bill amount. And now if you want to charge TCS on it, then you will click on Yes, otherwise select No, like we do Yes here. So in this way, the software will automatically charge TCS at the time of billing only. Then we will save the bill. After this, now let's see that when the buyer generate the purchase bill, then how they will generate the purchase bill along with the TCS. So now we will generate the purchase bill here, for which you will go to transactions menu, then to purchase, and then go to bill. Then select the ledger and take care of this thing that the supplier you have dealing with. Firstly, you will go to other details of that particular supplier and select TCS applicable from here. Now we will enter the party number, then select the item, and now press tab key and save the bill. Now you can see here that an alert message of TCS has been displayed, that is, this particular party does not have a PAN number and 0.10% TCS will be applicable on the bill amount. So if you want to charge TCS from this party, then select yes, otherwise no. Suppose we select yes here. And now the software will automatically charge TCS at the time of purchase bill. After that, now we will save the bill. After this, now let's see how you can print the TCS amount and percentage on the bill. For this, you will go to Masters menu, then to Marg Setups, and then go to Cell Format, then enter the password. And now you can print the TCS amount and percentage both in GUI and DMP format. So for now, we will select invoice format GUI, press enter key, come to the bill format, then to grand total, and now the selected part which you are viewing on the screen. You will select that selected part and copy it by pressing Ctrl C. Then go to the top of the window and press Ctrl V in order to paste that highlighted or selected part. Now press F1 key and search TCS. And then press enter key on TCS percentage field. And then you will select this part here and press F3 key in order to paste the command. Then here you will type TCS in a single quote and put a plus sign. And here also you will put a plus sign and put percentage sign in single quotes by giving a space. And now through this command, firstly TCS will appear, then percentage of the TCS will appear along with the percentage sign. After that, again we will press F1 key and search TCS and then press enter key on TCS amount. And now here you will select this part and press F3 key in order to paste that command. Like if there is no need of debit note and credit note commands, then you can remove them from here. And if you want, then you can keep it as it is. Then now press Ctrl W to save the commands. And by pressing escape key, you will come to the home screen of the software. After that, now again we will generate the sale bill. And like we have generated the sale bill here, then you will press tab key to save the bill. Now, in order to view the print preview of the bill, you will simply press F key from the keyboard. So now you can see that the TCS percentage and TCS amount has been printed on the bill. After this, now let's see the process of how you can file the TCS return. For this, you will firstly go to Masters menu, then to Marg Setups, and then click on TDS details. And here you will mention the tax deduction account number of the deductor, that is TAN, and PAN number of the deductor. And then mention the name of the authorized person, designation and place, and click on Accept. After this, go to GST menu. Then to TDS TCS reports and click on miscellaneous deductor detail. And here you will fill the required details of that person who will responsible for tax deduction and click on OK. Now after this, in order to file the return, go to GST menu, then to TDS TCS reports and then click on form 27EQ TCS. Then press spacebar key and select TCS on sales. Now firstly, you will select the TCS return period. And as you will select the period, all the other details will get auto-filled and will get displayed here. That is TAN, PAN, responsible person and designation. Then now click on view. So in this way, you can see that the details of the return will get displayed. Apart from this, you can also print it, export the details of the return in Excel and can view in GUI format also as per your requirement. So friends, in this way you can charge TCS from your parties with new amendments in Marg software. Thank you.